Okay, so let's now look at linear phase filter implementations. So how do we do that? Yeah, so remember we have got our symmetry condition here, so plus minus and then h of tau minus n equals to h of tau plus n. So this was our condition here. So what is this tau here now in a real implementation? So remember our FIR filter. So if we have here our FIR filter, and here we've got these so-called tabs, h of 1, and then this goes here to h of m minus 1 here, let's say, and m is a number of tabs. Then we need to create symmetry in the impulse response. So this h of n here needs to be symmetrical or anti-symmetrical. So this means for this m here is that this tau will be usually half of m. Yeah, so tau is then usually, let's do this again, this is m half. Yeah, so this that we have half of the tabs and then just mirror the impulse response here. Yeah, so this means that if we are looking at our coefficients here, so that's 0, this is m minus 1, and this is our h of n here, that in the middle here we are at m half, and then our impulse response must behave in the same way on both sides that we have here symmetry. Yeah, so we are essentially wasting half of our tabs for this here. So we have to have here the same impulse response on both sides, and then this filter is linear phase. So now with the knowledge that if m is the number of tabs, yeah, so or the number of coefficients, then our impulse response is generated by m half plus n equals to h of m half minus n, and then this can be plus or minus. So this means that we have here in the middle our m half, and then our impulse response needs to be symmetrical here. Yeah, so like this. So now it can be also obviously also anti-symmetrical like that. So now this is not the full story because these are actually samples here. Yeah, so these are not continuous values here, but we have samples, so single values here, for example here, or also here, yeah, so that we just sample the system. So now a problem arises, or not a problem, but what do we do here at the midpoint? Yeah, so how do we treat our symmetry at the midpoint here? So do we have, so how to create symmetry. Because there are two ways of doing this. So either we just have one sample here, and then, for example, this looks like this. Or the other option is we take this midpoint here, this M half, where this is, and double it up. Yeah, so that we have. Something like that, and then our midpoint is here. This obviously depends if our M is odd or even, and so therefore if we are actually having a midpoint or if we don't have a midpoint here. So we have got these two scenarios here. Yeah, so we've got the odd scenario here. And here we've got the even scenario. So with this knowledge, we can create different types of symmetries here. Yeah, so for example, the M is odd, then we could create an impulse response, which looks like that. And so h of n. So this one is called type 1 filter. So then obviously we can also do, so if we have M even, then what we do there then is basically doubling up the impulse in the middle. Yeah, so we've got our symmetry point here. And this is then called type 2. So then we can do the same, obviously, for our antisymmetric case here. So again, h of n. And so what we can do here in the so-called type 3 case, so if this is here again odd, then we have one sample is 0. Here in the odd case, and then in the even case we have something like this, that we don't have a sample which is 0 here, and so is our symmetry line is here. So odd and even, so this one is here, the odd one which is 0 is called type 3, and this one is here called type 4.